I've been walking through the wilderness, praying to the Father, and waiting for my time. I've come here with a mission, and soon I'll give my life for this world. I'm praying in the garden, and I'm looking for a miracle. I find the journey hard, but it's the reason I was born. And can this cup be passed on? Lord, I pray your will be done in this world. So I carry my cross, and I carry the shame to the end of the road, through the struggle and pain. And I'll do it for love. No, it won't be in vain. Yes, I carry my cross, and I carry the shame. I feel like I'm alone, and I'm treated like a criminal.
Dion, what's your last name, Dion?
Evans.
Dion Evans. Yes. Dion Evans is a pastor.
Yeah, close senior pastor at Chosen Vessels Christian Church in Alameda, California.
Oh, in Alameda. That's where I grew up, in Alameda.
Oh, you're a great man. You come from a great place.
I really enjoyed it there. Dion, could you tell me how you came upon this case and what your relationship is with Pastor Hoye and what you're doing?
Pastor Hoye and I are colleagues. We share the same pastor in Dr. Earl Stuckey, Progressive Missionary Baptist Church of Berkeley. And so he and I first got involved just in doing ministry. One day he came to me and said, hey, you know, I would like to have an opportunity to speak to the people at your church on the abortion issue. And we'd never done anything like that, but I felt that I trusted his integrity on the issue, and I didn't know a lot about it at the time. And I felt that just because I didn't know about it, it shouldn't stop the people from knowing about it. So we asked him to come in, and he did a conference, one-day conference on the subject, and blew our minds away, because up until then, I believed ignorantly, like many in the African-American community, that abortion is not something we do. Black folks don't do that. We don't endorse that. And so then here is a black pastor saying, yes, you do. And it was kind of earth-shattering for us. Even at that time, I didn't know, though I was given more information, I didn't know what to do with it. And so I just befriended him, started, you know, going around and befriending his movement. We were already friends. And so now I'm going around and meeting other people that are part of the movement. And I have a firm biblical view on it. I've always been pro-life, but I didn't know what it meant to deal with the other side. So when this issue came up about him being jailed for some ordinance, I didn't think it was really possible. Because who jails a preacher for standing on the sidewalk handing out a piece of paper and he's not hostile? Who gets in trouble for that? And so when we got the news that he was found guilty on what? And that's when we started digging more into what's going on. And he sent out an email shortly after that about his thoughts and how he was feeling. And I received that email like 10:30 on a Sunday night. And it grieved me so that I felt like I was a part of the problem. Because I hadn't been a part of the solution. And so I told my wife, I said, you know what, I'm going to leave the house for a bit. I need to go see this place that has so much power that a pastor can be sent to jail for passing out a piece of paper. And so I went there, and I see all these cameras everywhere, and I'm looking around, and I'm like, first thing I think is, well, if they got cameras, how come they didn't produce any video evidence? And so there's just been a lot of questions for me. In this, we have to love the people who are being unloving. And sometimes that's a challenge because they don't respect what we respect. But Walter's a brother beloved, and we will continue to champion this cause regardless of what happens on today.
Okay. Thank you very much. And is it okay if I put this up on my website?
Yeah, go right ahead.
Where's your church in Alameda?
So 710 Haight Avenue. Haight is spelled H-A-I-G-H-T. Okay. The website is www.alldifferent.org. And we have a lot of love on Haight Ave.
All right, good, very good. Thank you, Dion.
I've heard all the stories.
have him and Boris sit on the benches, and we just
have seen no other side.
Oh, you're right.
Witnessed all the glory.
Get them together.
Nothing compared to the greatness I know. You love. Nothing compares
those of us who are not
to the greatness I know.
Just let the Lord have his way. Those who feel it is important, if God has given them the desire to pray for this brother, feel free to pray for him. Amen?
Amen. Amen.
We'll ask Dr. Childress to give the final prayer. So as we're praying and there's a little bit of time and nobody's saying anything, Reverend Childress, can you go ahead and do the final prayer? And then we'll go from there. Amen? All right. Praise God. All right.
Why don't you start out?
Rosalind, you start out. We'll let him in.
Well, Lord, we just thank you for the conviction of your Holy Spirit, oh God, that's not addressed or hindered by those who believe, those who don't believe, because God, you are God.
Make way. Blocking the hallway.
And we thank you, Lord, that all that you have planned and designed will not be distracted or stopped, Lord, and that what you will do is prove yourself to be real. That you will prove yourself to be real to all that are here. That even for the authorities, Lord God, even for those that don't believe, those that do believe, oh God, you are still God all by yourself. And Lord, we ask you this day that you would come forth and show your glory, oh God, as we say yes to you, Lord. Yes to you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Lord, I thank you that no weapon formed against us shall prosper. I thank you for the life of Christ that's inside Walter, and I pray that would shine in the courtroom. Walter, I pray for conviction upon the judge that's in that courtroom, that the fear of the Lord would fall upon him, Lord, that the righteousness of Christ would prevail by your Holy Spirit in that courtroom, that the judge would find favor for Walter. So we ask these things in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, it is obvious that even in the time of prayer, there are those who strongly object your presence. And we know that you are a God of long suffering and a God of patience. And we know that whether they agree or not, you love them greatly. And because you have given them the ability to have life, we thank you for their life. And we know that they would rather be alive than to be sucked out. And so we thank you that you have given them life, and rather how they return life to others, they will have to answer to you one day. But we know, Father, that because you're still giving them breath, we believe that one day something will take place that will give them a crystal clear understanding and give them an understanding of the hope that you have been granting unto them as you have granted unto all mankind. And we bless you in the name of Christ.
Trust you and act in control. In your honor.